Hey everyone, what's up? This is Eric Merced, and this is part two of my Creating Comics in Procreate series. In this video, we're going to tackle layouts, or commonly known as thumbnails. So if you haven't seen part one of my Creating Comics in Procreate video, I highly recommend you stop this video and you go ahead and watch that video. In that video, I talk about how to set up a template that you can use inside of Procreate, either by downloading one from the internet or creating one with Medibang Paint. In this video, however, instead of using Medibang Paint, I'm going to go ahead and show you how I go about creating layouts inside of Procreate without the aid of any other app. Alright, so moving along here, we're going to go ahead and fire up Procreate. And I've already created an 11 by 17 page, which I've renamed Template. Let's open that up. And what I've done here is I've gone ahead and I've downloaded a comic book page template from the internet, and I'm using that as my basis for creating my layouts and creating my page. In my first video, in the video description, I have a link to the template that I'm using in that video and the template that I'm using in this video. So if you want to use the same template, you can go ahead and check that link out and give the artist a like and support his work as well. The one thing I want to mention before moving on is that I am currently using the 3.2 update for Procreate. Alright, so getting started here, I'm going to do a couple of things in preparation to make our layouts inside of Procreate. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to lock this template layer by swiping to the left and choosing lock. Now, like I mentioned, I'm using the 3.2 update of Procreate, and in that update, you are now able to lock your layers. Next, I'm going to create a new layer, and this is the layer that we're going to be working on. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to switch from a black color to a different color. I'm going to choose red because it'll be visually better to see what I'm doing in the video. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab an inking tool, and in this case, I'm using my lettering pen, but you can use any inking tool that comes with Procreate. Alright, so the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to zoom in here, and what I'm going to do is create a border with my lettering pen all across this page using the template, and I'm going to create that border in the live area. So basically what I'm doing here is I'm just using Procreate's quick line feature to create these lines across the page and keep them straight. Now if you look closely at this comic book template, it has a couple of areas where you can divide panels. So if you're not using this template in particular, I highly recommend that any template you grab will have these, because we're going to use these guides for our next step. So just like our first step, we're going to go ahead and create lines across the center of this border. All right, and after we do that, we're going to go ahead and grab our eraser tool, and we're just going to clean these lines up. It doesn't have to be perfect, but we're just going to separate the individual borders here. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect, because this is not going to be part of our final art. These are just basically guides that we're creating for our layouts, as you are going to see in the following step. Alright, now taking a step back and looking at what we've done, we've basically taken our live area and we've divided it into four different panels. Each one of these panels is going to represent a page. So basically, we have four panels that represent a page each for a total of four pages that we can use to lay out our comic. So now the next step we're going to take is that we're going to duplicate these four pages to make more panels just like this on our page. So we're going to go ahead and grab the transform tool. We're going to make sure that it's set to magnetic, and we're going to resize this layer. Next, we're going to duplicate this layer. We're going to select it again. And we're going to move it to the side. Now the thing here is to make each one of these the same size. So we're just going to transform them a bit until we get them to the size that we want. And that'll do it. The next step is we're going to merge both of these layers, duplicate them, and move the duplicate copy down the page. And finally, we're going to merge those layers. So when we're done, what we end up with is a page of 16 panels. Each one of those panels representing a page. So for example, if you were working on a 22 to 32 page comic, you'd only need two of these pages to lay out your entire comic. Next, I'm going to show you how I use this exact layout grid to lay out my comics. So I'm going to go ahead and switch back to a black color, and I'm going to turn transparency on this layer, and I'm going to fill it with black. Next, I'm going to lock the layer because I don't want to make any changes to that layer at the moment. And I'll create a new layer. Now it's in this new layer where I'm going to be working on my thumbnails. And to be clear, you can use as many layers as you want or as many layers as Procreate will allow you to use because of the document size. But I usually use just one layer. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom in here and create a pretend comic. I'm not working off of a script. I'm not working off of anything I've done in the past. I'm just going to go ahead and use my imagination to create a couple of pages of layouts of an imaginary comic. So I'm going to go ahead and grab a pencil brush and zoom in here. And I'm going to start laying out this comic. So maybe my first page will be a splash page of the hero swinging through the city. Now moving on to my second page, it'll have a couple of panels. So maybe there's a panel right on top here. And maybe another one below that one. And maybe a split panel in the bottom half. And maybe these could be a series of talking heads. So I don't want to get too crazy here with creating a whole bunch of layouts. I think two is enough just to give you an idea of how I use this template grid to create my layouts. The next thing I would do after all my layouts are created for my 16 or 32 pages or whatever is to take my layers that contain my layouts and merge them with my panels. So what I'll do is I'll just go ahead and merge those two layers like so. The next thing I'll do is I will work with each layout individually. So for example, since this is my first page, I'm going to go ahead and do and tap on my selection tool, and I am going to select this first page here and single it out from all of the other layouts. With three fingers, I'm going to swipe up and I'm going to choose copy. All right, and then the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get out of this file and I'm going to go to a new page file that I've created for that first page. And the next thing I'm going to do is go ahead and with three fingers, I'm going to swipe up and choose paste. And that'll bring that copied layout page into this new page. With magnetic on, I'm going to go ahead and resize this to fit into the page. Just like so. Then I'm going to unselect it, and as you can see, I've taken my layout, or my thumbnail layout, which was in a much smaller size, and I've resized it to fit into the actual page. So this is how I lay out my comics. This is how I use this grid to lay out all of my comics, and I will go ahead and copy and paste individually from my layouts into a new page as I move along. And now I can use this page as a basis to flesh out my entire page. So I hope you found this video educational, and I hope it helps you in the process of creating comics with Procreate on the iPad Pro. Stay tuned for part 3 of creating comics in Procreate. It's currently in development as we speak. And if you like this video, please show me some support by hitting the like button. If you haven't subscribed and you want to keep up with this series or any new videos that I post, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Until then, thanks for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Stay creative and create great things. God bless you all.